Hello, YouTube world. MacDaddy1911A1 here with the Shade Tree Survivalist. Check it out, guys. Ain't she purty? This is my new Squad Scout that I just picked up today, the 9th of April. And no, this is not a gift to myself for my birthday. This is a acquisition I've wanted to make for quite a while so that I actually have another 308 rifle that not only is compatible in magazines, ammunition, and so forth with old Betsy, but is a little shorter for patrolling and inside the house and so forth. As you can see, first thing I did is mount my little Siemens Red Dot to it, and it fits perfectly. And I still am going to have to add a cheek riser so that my eyes level with the back of the sight so that the Red Dot is centered up and so forth. But the great thing is it's so low profile, I can still see the front, front sight. When I was in the store looking at it, the rear sight, I thought it was quite a bit smaller, the rear aperture, but actually it is not. But the black front sight in any kind of darkened area, it is easy to lose. So I'm going to have to paint either a white line or something around it. What I'm thinking about doing is taping just the very edge of it, and that's going to be very hard to do, but tape the very edge and put a brilliant white stripe right down the center of the front sight. And being it's very thin to start with, it's probably going to be a little bit of a pain in the ass, but who knows, we shall see. But unlike the original rifle, this is not a muzzle brake, or excuse me, a flash suppressor. This is definitely a muzzle brake, and it is designed to prevent the barrel from rising up and push the recoil right back into the shooter's shoulder. And that's exactly what we want. You know, at a later date, who knows, I may upgrade with a tritium front sight as well as the tritium rear sight, the much bigger, wider ghost ring versus the tiny aperture that like Betsy has, and the small aperture that this one has. It's not a huge hole in the rear. I might do a close-up on it in just a moment. We shall see. But yeah, the little Siemens Red Dot, it works good. I will have to have a cheek riser, and I'm thinking about one of the Bradley cheek risers. We shall see on that one also. I may make one out of Kydex and try it out on this the plastic stock. Who knows? We shall see. Well, I tell you what, let's do a quick close-up of the rear sight, and then we'll do a quick close-up of the front sight and the muzzle brake, shall we? Okay, here's the rear sight. You can see the aperture hole is quite big, but it's not a true ghost ring. Ghost ring, the hole would be 3-4 times bigger than that, and that would be for very fast sighting. And that's what the CQB type rifles that they have out. The SOCOM 16s have a much bigger sight, but you can see Kim is being my model right now. And this here is looking through. As long as it's focusing on the other wall, we can see the dot. Back it out a little bit and have it focus on the front, and it turns to that. It's huge. It's the weirdest thing ever. But the forward mounted optic, you'll see over the sight, and that's what you see. But look at how much you can see to the left and to the right. That's the point of the scout optic, the scout rail forward of the ejection port for the action. Okay, that's the smallest, dimmest dot setting that I've got on this little sight. And you can see what it looks like. It's just a dot. I mean, there's no fancy chevron or anything of that nature. But the idea is to be able to see through the sight, see the dot, and at the same time, because it's forward mounted in the scout configuration, you can see to the left with your left eye and your strong eye if you're shooting right eye, of course. you can see off to your right, and that's the point. So you can, you're looking over your rear sight, back it out. You're looking over your rear sight to the front, and you see right through the front of the red dot, but you can also see side to side and have a great field of vision, so that if a fast moving target gets beyond the optics capability or its shadows at the sides, you know, blank out your target, you can see it in your peripheral vision real quick, real easy. Pop a shot into it. End of argument. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, to answer all the questions, yes, there's, I've had three different stocks. I've got this original wooden walnut stock that Betsy came in. This is her original stock. I have a GI fiberglass stock. That was the one that was sort of mangled up, camouflage. And then I have the new plastic, black plastic stock that came with it. But don't it look good in wood? Before it's all said and done, there will be a 2x7 Burris Scout scope on here, but that's for future purchase. And whichever stock I decide to go with will have the original steel butt plate. But for now, what I've got is Butimus, and I'll stick with it. So tomorrow, we'll do some shooting. This is MagDaddy 1911A1. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to put the old girl through the paces. Thank you very much for watching.